Okay, the quality's worse now. But hopefully it'll actually work. That'd be cool. Okay, are we gonna actually be able to see it now? Or will it just be like, nope, I don't allow this again? Because that would suck. Oh my god, we actually have video. There we go, perfect. I can even hear myself, which I hate, but you know what? Hey, that's cool. Well, okay. Hey, Productions. I'm gonna keep calling you by that full name instead of using your normal name. Where did I even get to last time? Well, I need... Okay, so the purpose of this stream is basically I'm going to, number one, be totally hyping about Bayonetta in Smash, but number two, people were mad that I missed a weapon in my Bayonetta playthrough, Bayonetta 2 playthrough, rather. I got called out for accidentally calling it Bayonetta also. So, just gonna Google, just so I know exactly where to go. Bayonetta 2 weapon locations, there we go. How dare you? No, how dare you, Project Phoenix Productions? I just noticed the three. Since I get it. Okay, so let's see here. Okay, so the last one. Nope, that's for Bayonetta 1. Bayonetta 2. Here we go. Wait, which one don't I have? I have Chernabog. I don't think I have Takamikazuchi. That's the one I think I missed. Also, Wikipedia, could you not be a jerk? Thank you. Okay. Chapter 8 first is the first one. Got it. All happy with the Smash reveals? You freaking know it. Bayonetta in Smash is like my favorite thing to ever happen in games ever. Let's see, what do I want to put her in? Let's see here, let's go actually Bayonetta 2 style, like Smash Bros. Bayonetta style weapons, just the normal. Okay, so verse 5 in this level, got it. God, I love Bayonetta. Like, and the fact that I can, just from watching the trailer, was able to recognize all these moves. Like, it's so good. So we need verse 5 and verse 7. You know what? I can skip the... I can skip this one now.
Try to keep up.
No. Okay, no, I need to actually go further ahead before I start exploring and stuff. I was wanting to speedrun it, Loki. Gosh. I'm surprised in your Cloudfest you didn't do the materia, though. If it's 8-player Smash, the materia is disabled, actually. That's how they get around that. Okay, well, haven't played for a while. That's okay, mistakes happen. Oh my god. What? Okay. You know what? He's enraged, that's why. Wow, okay, hard mode, harder than I remember. Wow, That was terrible. Okay, maybe if I'm on hard mode, maybe I should not use the, especially jumping right to the end, you know? I should probably not put on the Enrage All Enemies weapon. That might be why I got destroyed so quickly. Let's see here. I want my blocks and I want mechs. There we go. Perfect. Okay, I can't apparently parry a grab, which makes sense by Street Fighter law. But he can parry me, which I absolutely hate. Okay, gotta get back into it, cause I was playing this on the hard, cause I'm on hard difficulty now, and I was actually playing it earlier, and it wasn't too bad, but now that I'm like, I jumped ahead a good number of levels compared to where I was before, yeah. So let's see here. Wanted to also try and find any other items I missed in my actual playthrough. No, I'm not gonna wait for you. I think, was it something over here? Because people were saying, like... Oh, no, no, that's death.
Try to keep up.
Man, I'm so happy Bat Within is the bottom special. Like, did the down B. Because that's such a... Like, that's so key to Bayonetta's character, you know? Out of interest, playing with the Pro Controller or the GamePad? Well, the Wii U Pro Controller is probably my favorite controller of all time, so I'm definitely playing with the Pro Controller. The GamePad, it's good for games, don't get me wrong, I like the GamePad, but man, it works so much better with the Pro Controller, because, you know, it fits so much nicer, it's lighter, it's, you know, all that good stuff. I need to start buying the other techniques, because I want to be totally have everything by the little stomp. That's probably a good one, because this is like, it lets you hit OTG, and it all this is back forward A, you know, so
beautiful.
Yeah, like that's Bayonetta's down smash, and will probably be very good to use. Now, does that use the meter?
Beautiful.
It does use meter. Okay, well, that makes sense. It is summoning. I have to purchase a Pro Controller as my gamepad broke. Oh, that sucks. Never had any, really anything break for me. I'll need a replacement gamepad for Star Fox and Zelda, yeah, for sure. I think they're selling new ones now. And I'm pretty sure you can ask Nintendo and, like, they'll repair them. I'm pretty sure. I'm not exactly sure, like, I heard about a service, but that might be Japan only, or America only, so. My friend's asking, are we still hanging out? Well, Adrian, I'm going to tell him yes, but just later. Yeah. I'm just streaming for now. When you come over, I'll stop. There we go. Cool. I should play you in Tay Climax. I have this game. Nah, I have stuff I want to unlock for single player, which is why I'm here, because I have a lot of stuff that I missed. Not now, though. Okay. Not entirely sure about the money difference between Canada and... But it costs 150 euros from Nintendo, so that's about $300. Okay.
Just remembered.
Oh, you just remembered. That's good. Thank you, Loki. It's so weird. A pre-owned pad would be... Okay, that's not as bad. 70 euros, or pounds, I don't know. It's so cool how they just added a mode where you play as a different character and they just, like, reuse Bayonetta's everything. I actually really love it. Well, they did that, you know, in the last one, too, with another character. And I want to unlock the last story mode of Abel character. Whoa, okay, I didn't actually mean to do that, but that was actually super cool. I love tank mode. Oh wow, okay, that hit for a lot. That's the thing about Bayonetta. It's like the hard mode, just enemies hit really hard. Like, oh, that's tough. What's the difference between the two characters? Basically, Jeanne hits harder, but she doesn't slow down time when you just dodge. You actually have to get hit at the last second, then dodge. Like, it's actually a really crazy system. Like, there, I got hit, but because I nullify the damage with the dodge, I was able to get slowdown. With Bayonetta, it's just whenever you dodge, and overall, it's much easier for that. But Jeanne is, you know, harder to play as because she has less HP. She takes, you know, more damage. But otherwise, it's funny because the story is about them trying to save Jeanne, so they don't change the story at all. So it's literally Jeanne trying to save Jeanne, and even Bayonetta's voice is the same. It's basically a special costume, but in gameplay she has different voice clips, but in cutscenes she doesn't. Whoa, okay, that sucked. Also, she swears a lot more. Bayonetta only swears when necessary. Jeanne swears whenever the heck she feels like it. There we go. Jeanne takes more skill, that's for sure, yeah. But she also is super stylish, so that's good. Sadly, no short hair. She's back to long hair. But conversely, Bayonetta now has a short hair, so it's all good. Yeah, this is definitely a lot close. Wait, what verse am I on? Because I need to be at verse 5. Okay, that's okay. I don't think I'm there yet. Her witch time takes better reaction. Yep. No, did I check behind me here? Yeah, she's tougher, but she's more fun. Yeah, we will. Just hold your horses, buddy. Hey, buddy. I'm a Canadian. That was a mistake, but thankfully falling off the world doesn't kill you in this one. I actually really like that. Someone pointed out it's because you can fly at any time in this game, so like, it's no big deal when they fall off. It's like, it's wonderful. Look at all these fusion parts I'm not actually going to use much. Okay, this is verse 5, okay. Trying to find all the CD parts? Yep, that's me. I missed the one for the big hammer. So I'm gonna need that for my playthrough because, you know, we gotta get all those weapons and show them off and stuff. Also, again, just Bayonetta hype to the fact. You know, she's in Smash, something that I wanted but never thought would happen. Okay, I tried to parry that. Don't try and parry dudes who are all gold. Just a pro tip. It's not worth it, because he can parry you. God, this guy is crazier on hard mode. Wow, okay, this is tough. Screw Bayonetta, I want Tails and Nux in Smash. Well, yeah, they are. What's the big problem?
The shadow remains cast.
Hard mode is hard. It's so weird that there's a character in Smash who says, just straight fuck off. Like, like, I mean, you know, like, we had Snake, but he doesn't swear much. He keeps it pretty, like, Metal Gear Solid could be an a T-rated game. And then there's like, man, I love it. So good. Out of here. We'll get around to playing Bayonetta 1 or 2 at some point, just gotta get my controller though. It's a good game. I really think Bayonetta is like the required reading of video games. I gotta say. Okay, so this is where we got the one part I remember. So the next one is let's see here. Verse 7. After the verse is over, behind the portal Loki opens that requires you to jump through it. Yeah. They should have made an actual Jeanne skin. You know what? I'm perfectly fine with giving it a... well, because then that would require a whole bunch of new assets, like new voice clips and stuff, and I'm happy with them even putting in just a color reference, and that color is, like, my favorite color. And I actually think it serves a double purpose, because I don't know if you noticed the red coat with white hair combo Bayonetta's rocking in that color, because that's... I honestly think it's a double reference to not only just, to Jeanne, but to Dante as well. Like, maybe it's just me looking, but, like, Devil May Cry was, like, was partially the inspiration for this, where they couldn't make a new Devil May Cry game because Capcom fired all the Clover staff, so they went to form, Platinum Games, and, you know, by doing that, they gotta hit them all nice, you know, so it's like, they put in the reference to Dante because it's the inspiration for Bayonetta. At least that's my view on it. You know, I could be wrong. I could be looking far. With slower witch time and takes more damage, but is more powerful than Bayonetta. Yep, that's true. Okay, so let's straight pole dance on this. Well, it's not really. Actual characters, don't get me wrong. I like the costumes, but I want the actual characters. Oh, okay. You know what, honestly, all the Mii costumes, again, maybe I'm the only one who sees it like this. I'm totally okay with Mii costumes because I honestly think they look fine. They look good. And, you know, aside from the Mii's face, which, you know, some people might not like, I think all the Mii costumes look totally fine and replaceable as the characters. Like, the Geno Mii looks exactly like Geno. Like, that's how Geno would look. Aside from the face being slightly off, and if you get a good Geno Mii, it looks fine. So...
Yeah.
To be fair, I might have also liked the mech as Bayonetta's final smash, although her final smash is insane. I'm actually so excited for it because it's like, it really does the whole system of Bayonetta well, you know? Okay, that was verse 7. So they said it's after he opens the... Let me read here again. After the verse... Behind the portal, Loki opens. Okay. Got it. Sounds good. I don't know why there's so many shops in this one. Like... Oh, I think I see it there. Slow down, will ya? Ah, sneaky. I found it. So then, do I have 2 of 3 now? Yes. Okay, so the next one is right? It's actually in 9, verse 6, before the golem. Got it. So now I just have to, hidden dudes. Hi. I just parried a projectile. That's my favorite feeling, is parrying projectiles in this game, honestly. Okay, that was a mistake. I couldn't see what's going on. I love it. I love it so much. Man, this game's so good. Can I go through this way? Nope. Okay, this is a mistake. This is a mistake. Oh no, it's sweet. I did it. Cool.
Never give up, do they?
I hate the shield guys. Those are my least favorite enemies in the game. Especially with Jeanne, because there we go. Okay, so let's focus on him for now because I hate him. They couldn't put devils in the Bayonetta stage? Well, there are no devils when you fight on that one, though. Like, I mean, it's exactly like the intro of Bayonetta 1, and there were no devils in the intro to Bayonetta 1. Cause, like, it was just the angels. God, that stage looks so good, though. That, I'm actually gonna pick... Whoa, hello, I saw an item up there that I didn't get before. I'm gonna get back up there. This is gross. I hate Jeanne's transformation. That's really gross. I don't like that. Hello. You're a bird. How do I get said bird? I got you. I got the bird. There's so many birds that I've missed. Yuck. I hate this transformation. The snake, I'm down with. This, I'm not. These guys are a bit annoying, too. You know what? I'm gonna switch just for these guys. I'm actually kind of happy being stuck to just her weapons. Like, I guess some people would probably want it to be, you know, her entire arsenal. But just by having it focused on her having her main weapons, it's a lot more focused, you know? I didn't even see this guy. I wish the skip was the was one button, but you know what? Can't have everything. I will say one of my favorite sort of ways of doing a game is having it be a short game that you can replay in like a day. And this is like, this is it, man.
Try to keep up.
Did I do this one? Yes, okay. I love the whole idea of just a game that you can clear in one day, you know? Because it just makes me so much more into it. All right, this golem. Oh, I didn't even notice that he rides on your head in this scene. That's actually so amazing. I also find it just weird that you only play as Loki for one entire verse in the game. Like, that's it. Like, that's just a little weird.
Right then.
No, I didn't miss it. The next piece is, it's in the next chapter, not verse.
Diplomacy is...
So let's see here. I want to get next, Tetsuzanko. So let's see here. See how good this is. I mean, it's the back forward, but... Oh my god, it tracks. I didn't think you would track. That's so good. Let's see here. Build up a bit of meter. Oh, that's good. I like that. I like that a lot. Boom. Tetsuzanko. I love that. That's straight from Virtua Fighter. That's another thing I love. Platinum Games loves all the old school fighting games and stuff. And they put in references to basically anything and everything, and it makes me happy. Does cleanup mean that Jeanne is trying to catch up Bayonetta and is doing what she left behind? Basically, yeah. God mech battle! Yo, let's go! Why was that the greatest thing, but only lasted a few moments? Oh, I should've dodged that. I'm trying to offset my dodges by making them slower so I can get stuff like this. Oh, come on. That's why you gotta mash the dodge button, you know, in situations like that. That was so good. That was so good. Man, this game just gets me hyped. When you do good, you know? It's like, you feel it in your core.
That
you're like,
easy.
Damn. I love video games. Yeah, will do. Okay, let's try and hit them all. Oh, I missed one again. There goes that achievement. Right, so the next one is, chapter 9, verse 6. Wow, I just realized, chapter 9, verse 6, they're literally doing it like the Bible. Like, I only now got it, you know? Like, that's wonderful, that's great. So let's see here. I guess I could have changed my costume, that's okay.
Bring it! I'm going to make you suffer in this life and the next.
I love that the, frickin', she gets, like, in Bayonetta and Smash, gets super long taunts. and that they put that in and you can cancel them though. So it's like, it's like Bayonetta, you know? So you can cancel your taunts at any time. You know, that's wonderful. And we haven't had taunt cancel. We haven't had taunt canceling since Smash 64. This is real tech, guys. This is the real gaming tech that we need. So. Give me my sweet items, though. All these baked geckos I'm never really gonna use. Hello. Is that an item up there that I missed? Or was I just confused?
Not that way.
Shut up, Loki. No, I guess I might have just been seeing. I'm gonna try, though. Oh, I don't think so. No, don't think so. So what we got now? I forget. All right, these weird things. These things look like something straight out of Knights. Like the Sega game. Again, if it was an inspiration, but... I could just play the action of this game forever. Like, I don't need, like, I know some people are like, man, platinum games are so short. And I just want to say, like, yeah, but I'd rather have a short, perfect experience to a long, dragging one. Like, if your game's like 5,000 hours of entertainment included, it's like, I don't want to play that. I really don't. It's just give me a nice short experience, and then we'll talk, you know. Nothing else in here. Just gotta check. Gotta do my cleanup. Can't wait to the part where we have Jeanne save Jeanne, because that's, wow, that sounds like the voice actor for Duke Nukem. Jeanne save Jeanne.
Try to keep up.
So this is verse what? 4. Okay. Get out of here. Get out of here. So that doesn't do super damage, but it's a visual spectacle, so I'm down with it. Oh man, come on. That could have been a pure platinum. That's really sad. Oh wait, no, it wouldn't have been, because this guy... My summon swords too. I love it. Starting to feel the witch time with Jeanne a bit more, because, you know, it's the whole thing of you gotta get hit first to actually witch time with her. There we go. So wait, we need verse 6. That was verse 5. Oh no, that's verse...
Not bad.
Now this next one will be verse... A bird! I gotta get that bird. Bird, there we go, nice. 13. We got some. So what's down here, though? I don't think I've been down here. Have I? Ah, oh, there it is. Perfect. It's not even verse 6. It's right here. Nice. We got it. 3 of 3. We got, Kim's gold LP, The Harmonious Blacksmith. I like how they're all actual songs, too. Like, that's just a small, nice touch. And hello, there is a Gates of Hell over there. Meaning we can go and actually get it and give it a shot. Let's try out the one new weapon that we missed. Cool, I wonder what else that means we gotta do. Another for this LP.
No, here we go, let's see. Wicked.
Even last
if I
one.
Am jollier than the average demon, but no need to pity me. I was bored anyways. Be right back. This one's gonna be fun.
Oh wait, no, we do have one more. If we beat all the stuff with the entire third climax mode, which is possible for sure.
You better be happy I like you, Bayonetta. If I didn't, I'd be charging you hazard pay for this one. Now go make me proud.
Oh, it's Yagi. Oh no, because we're it's Takumi Kazuchi for. Oh, cool. Umbrin thingy for that. I'm gonna definitely get that when I get the chance. But yeah, no, it's Takumi Kazuchi for Bayonetta. But for Jeanne, it's something else, because, you know, you gotta differentiate the names. They're not the same person, even though he literally just said Bayonetta. Oh, I can't wait to try it out, though. Can we just get rid of these? Thank you. I don't want those anymore. It's a big-ass hammer, which makes me excited. Because hammers are cool. And I will not... Kate, no, go away. I will not say stop hammer time once. I might say it more than once. Just a heads up. Nope. Let's go back. Let's just put it on our hands here. Let's see here. Yagyu. True to its name, which means wild bull. This enormous hammer houses a charm blessed by the raging bull god Gozu. Not to be confused with Gozer. Some time ago, Rodan used this hammer during a fight to save a planet... in crisis. Yo, that's wonderful 101. That's canon. That makes sense. That's so cool. Because I remember, I'm like, why does he have a hammer in the wonderful 101? Rodan's in the wonderful 101. Nice. Rodan has since made it powerful for Jeanne traveling to Japan to find and affix a new charm. Let's give it a shot. Let's see what it looks like. Yo! Yo! That's disgusting looking! Let's give this a shot and see what its combos are like. I don't think you'll be able to put this on your feet for obvious reasons, so let's give it a shot. Oh my god! That's pretty gross! You can stinger with it, which is good. I wanna give it a shot. I wanna use it. I wanna use it so bad, guys. It's slow, so people might be like, oh, it's worthless. But you know what? Slow big hits are cool. Oh my god! It doesn't seem to have a hold move, which is a bit sad, but... That's really gross! I love it so much! Oh my god, I love it so much.
Pride of the Umbra.
Oh, that is so powerful. So gross. Let's do this thing. Come on out, Golem. Yeah. Actually, you are. You're a bird now. I don't like birds. God, it's so slow, but I don't care. Oh, come on. Get those blade beams out of here. You're not in Smash. Let's hit!
Be gone.
Oh, cool. He actually becomes, Legola. Or, yeah, the bonus boss. Okay, I didn't actually know that. That's actually kind of cool. Of course, he fires lasers. Okay, of course, I keep getting hit by the lasers. Okay, I hit the dodge button there. Or not. That's cool. Okay. The weapon, that was the fault of me. So, don't... It's a good weapon. It's a really fun weapon.
Your turn. Be gone.
Like, can you imagine if Bayonetta had the parry in Smash Bros? Absolutely broken she would be. Like, I imagine, like, you know, of course people are already like, oh my god, Bayonetta is so broken, you know, but like, that they make every newcomer look broken, but man, she has a lot of options. Okay, that was fast. That was faster than I expected. Okay, that I was pretty sure I hit the dodge button for. That was my fault entirely. It's actually safest to, like, be inside of them. Like, that's such a weird thing about Bayonetta. The safest place is, like, right under them. Oh, I hate the speed of this dude. Oh, I was trying to pause and do the thing. Okay. Trying to pause and heal. I love the difficulty though, honestly. I love, like, this is one thing I like about Platinum Games over definitely other even similar game companies is that when you die, it's like the worst thing is you lose score. It's like, there's no freaking... I just got a notification, oh, for class that I'm not going to today. I have a final today. It's not like a Dark Souls game where it's like you lose bits of your maximum health and there's permanent repercussions to dying. It's like, you just do good, you know? It's like, you just keep trying till you do good. Yeah, you lose points, but who cares about points in the end, you know? It's like, I know I don't. I'm gonna try and build up more meter, though. Oh, that was cool. That was cool.
Be gone.
Okay, so even with larger witch meter, it doesn't actually last that long. Okay, I didn't know that. I don't even know what this thing is. Like, this form. It's stupid is what it is.
Nerza.
So happy it took two games for that to actually work. Get it? Punchline? Cause it's, we punch it? Ooh, jokes! Oh right, there's a boss fight here with this dude. Oh my god, I love just whacking him with it. It's so good. And it staggers too. Can we get the mech in the air? Cause if so, I'll be super hype. Can.
You are not even an insect. Let me roll your sentiments.
Oh, man.
Sentinels.
Oh, come on, Kay. I should have been able to hit him before that. Okay, let's heal up a little bit. Just. There we go. Just enough to keep us alive. Oh, these dodge offsets, though. Oh, this is tough. Get out of here. Or would it be Muda, since I'm more like the Dio, you know? Okay, let's heal a little bit more. Why the bracelets of ruin? Because hype. I know it's not hype. I should probably be using the instant witch time one though. You're right. Celine's light? Yes. Oh no, that's not the instant witch time one. I don't have the instant witch time one. Oh, I want that final hit to hit. Oh, come on. Come on. I died right there. Damn it. Okay. I was sure I hit the dodge button there. This is tough. This is tough on this difficulty. Gotta say. You know what? I might... Okay, so this is fun and all, but I think I might switch back over to, the all four... Angel Slayer might be fun. I think I'll switch back to All for One. And, let's see here. Instant time, no. I don't know. It's probably the best one for now.
You're vanquished.
Oh, the range on that is gross. Oh, come on. The timing for the witch time is so tough.
function.
Back off!
Oh, this is fun. Oh, this is tough, but oh, this is fun. One more time. Muda, 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 muda. Get out of here, you gross man. Oh, that was lame. If you, I instinctively now dodge and press parry at the same time. It's probably the worst thing to do, but I love it. One more item. Okay, just no big deal. I know it's the scrubby thing to do, but you know what? I am a scrub. At IMAX.
Be gone.
Get out of here. I just parried that. That's so hype.
I'll crush you.
It's a miracle.
One thing I will say about these boss fights is that, like, when you're in the air, it removes the verticality aspect of the fight, which actually is, you know, makes it tougher. Because you're stuck on a 2D plane. There's no jumps, you know? So it's like, that actually changes quite a bit. Boom. Oh my god. Whew! That was, third climax, man. This is Bayonetta difficulty, you know? Though, to be fair, this is like what normal was for Bayonetta. Bayonetta 1's normal was like this third climax, and I actually heard people say it. And we're gonna skip these because we've seen them.
Simply a matter of time.
Now we're actually gonna go back in levels, though. Because we need to, I still have other levels I need to do. The only thing I didn't unlock is Rosa. Spoilers, you unlock Rosa. No, I know you unlock Rosa, but she, you have to beat it on Infinite Climax if what I've heard is correct. Which, it's
worse.
Either that or get all gold in third climax, which I have no idea. Bayo 1 was so hard. Yeah, it was. And I'm okay with that. So let's just see here. Menu, play history. What levels didn't I do in the middle? I need to do 6 and 7. Okay. Ah, 6 is one of my favorites, so I'm super hyped. 6 is a really good level. Like, oh my god, guys. Well, no, there's 6 people watching. Let's see here. How much moolah do I have? Enough for a new technique? Let's see here. Which twist, oh, I remember I couldn't do these ones. These ones are weird. I don't like those ones so much. You know what? I think I'm good for those for now. I want to try and start getting the essences and stuff. You're right. No, where's the essence? Oh, right, you can't get them with, Jeanne. Which is weird. I guess there's the other accessories, too. Weapons... I don't really need the other weapons, but I think it's whatever. I'm gonna get them all eventually, because, I mean, there's so much stuff to buy, so... I'm just gonna keep buying stuff forever. Let's switch up our costumes. Let's see here. Let's go back to old school style, Jeanne. Did you mine for halos yet? I did a couple times. I can always go back and do more, and I will. That'll be later. I don't know about this costume. Like, I like the hair. I don't like the poofy neck thing. For sure. Like, it's weird. Did she actually get a different beast, too? Or is it the same? I think it's the same. God, I love games with just lots of extra costumes. It's absolutely my favorite thing.
New model, huh? I hope this one lasts a little bit.
You know, that's a big cut if you don't know the cutscene before it. Like, that's, if you skip cutscenes, you're in for surprises. Also, if you skip cutscenes in a game like this, you are a sad individual who doesn't deserve to play video games. I know people who always skip cutscenes. Like, in every game. They say it's needless. They're like, that's dumb. Then again, I also know people who completely skip gameplay. They're just like, no, it's like, I don't want to play the game for the game. I want to play it for the, only the story. And it's like, well, the game is definitely a necessary part of the story, you know? But no, it's, yeah. I'm not gonna use my climax just yet. I punched him all the way over there, though. That's pretty cool. Oh, it hit me on the rebound, though. Being like this, I thought it wasn't. I didn't know that this one was actually arena based. I thought it was like still falling and stuff. It's weird. Did I do something different, or I don't know. Maybe I just didn't remember it the same. I thought this part was like the last one.
Whew.
God, this game is... Like, they really... Like, they said they want to give you that climax feeling, and man, oh man, oh man, you get it.
Get a new one of those.
It's funny, because Bayonetta's voice fits with Jeanne quite a bit. Can't skip it. Oh, right, there's more to this level. No, or is the next... No, the next level is a different one, because it's the arc, right? Bronze, I'll take it. Get that sick, sick bonus, though.
Not that bad, I guess.
All right, though. I think since I will be having a friend over later, I should probably go clean up and stuff. So thank you all for watching, guys. This was super fun. Hopefully I'll do more in the future. We'll have to see. But yeah, until then, we'll see you next time. Ciao.